Welcome again. Right now, we're in the book of Romans, chapter 2, verses 17, all the way through to the end of the chapter, verse 29. And we're talking about hypocrisy and circumcision. Indeed, you bear the name of a Jew, rest on the law, in other words, you rest on the Torah, glory in God, know his will, and approve the things that are excellent, being instructed out of the law, and are confident that you yourself are a guide of the blind, a light to those who are in darkness, a corrector of the foolish, a teacher of babies, having in the law, the Torah, the form of knowledge and of truth. You, therefore, who teach another, don't you teach yourself? You who preach that a man shouldn't steal, do you steal? Paul is speaking to the saints in Rome. He wrote a letter, okay? Actually, we are reading somebody else's mail right now. This really wasn't written for us, okay? Paul never thought about us when he wrote this stuff. He wrote it, it says in Romans chapter 1, to the saints in Rome, to those Jews and Gentiles who believe in Yeshua, HaMashiach, Jesus the Christ, as their Messiah, those who obey God, those who know the Lord, okay? The saints in Rome, that is the audience here. Those are whom these words are for. Verse 22, you who say a man shouldn't commit adultery, do you commit adultery? You who abhor idols, do you rob temples? These are temples of idols he's talking about. You who glory in the law, in other words, you who boast in the Torah, do you dishonor God by disobeying the Torah? For, quote, the name of God is blasphemed among the Gentiles because of you. That is Isaiah chapter 52, verse 5, and Ezekiel chapter 36, verse 22. Just as it is written, for circumcision indeed profits, if you are a doer of the law. But if you are a transgressor of the law, your circumcision has become uncircumcision. In context here, you see, Paul is speaking to a very, very particular group right now. He's speaking to those who judge other people for doing the same things they do, okay? Not judging people for doing the same things they used to do. No. That doesn't count. But judging people, condemning people for doing the things that they presently do. You see, Paul is very slowly here moving in on the hypocrites, okay? He's not talking to everybody now. He's not talking to all the saints in Rome now. Obviously, he's talking about those who are hypocrites within that group, okay? So he's honing in on them right now. He's saying, you guys, you particular people, you know who I'm talking about. You guys are hypocrites. You think that circumcision is just, that's going to profit you everything. It's like if you get circumcised, then you're fine. You know, it's almost like today in Christian circles with baptism. It's like if you get baptized and you believe, you're saved. It doesn't matter how much of a hypocrite you are. Oh, yeah? Really? That's not what I read in the scriptures. Paul continues, if the uncircumcised keep the ordinances of the law, won't his uncircumcision be counted as circumcision? In other words, Paul is saying here, listen, what counts the most, okay, is what is in the heart. If you have truly repented, if you truly have a heart for God, self-sacrifice, you're denying yourself, and you are following the ways of God, you have turned your heart to God. That is what counts more than just outward motions. Not to throw away the outward motions, but the outward doesn't prove the inward, okay? Just because it glitters on the outside doesn't mean the whole thing is gold, is what Paul is saying here. Verse 27, won't the uncircumcision, which is by nature, if it fulfills the law, judge you? When Paul says the uncircumcision, he's referring to the Gentiles. You see, in those days, it was the Jews only that got circumcised. The Gentiles did not get circumcised. So the Jews were the circumcision, and the Gentiles were called the uncircumcision. Won't the uncircumcision, which is by nature, if it fulfills the law, judge you? who with the letter and circumcision, the letter here meaning the Torah and circumcision, are a transgressor of the law? For he is not a Jew who is one outwardly. In other words, you can pretend to be a Jew and really not be a real Jew on the inside. It's very simple. Neither is that circumcision, which is outward in the flesh, but he is a Jew who is one inwardly. And circumcision is that of the heart, in the spirit, not in the letter, whose praise is not from men, but from God. You see, outward circumcision of the body, the physical body, is just a sign of the inward circumcision of the heart. Again, it's almost like the Christians today that get baptized saying this is a sign that we are born again. We die to self and then we're risen again, okay? And so the circumcision on the outside is a sign of the circumcision on the inside. So you can be circumcised on the outside, but not really be circumcised on the inside. And same with, you can be circumcised on the inside, circumcision of the heart. That is God cutting away the stony, hard heart. The hard heart that doesn't care about God's word. You know, you're hard against God's ways. You're hard against what God has to say. You just put on a hard front, okay? You won't let the word of God penetrate you. That's having a hard heart. You won't let godly sorrow fill you because you have a hard heart. You know, you don't feel anything. You have a heart of stone. So God can cut that away, circumcise the heart. So your heart is very, very soft. Very, very soft. So this is what we're talking about here. The inward circumcision and the outward circumcision. The inward circumcision is more important, not to leave the outward circumcision undone. Today, seek God with all your heart. We've been talking a lot about the heart. Seek God with all your heart today, right now. Don't let another night go by. Seek God right now. That means pull out the Bible. That means read the scriptures. That means pray. Whatever you have to do to press into God. Press in to God. Put down your own agenda. Put down that busy life. Put down your own opinions, your own feelings, and get into the scriptures and say, God, I want to know what you have to say more than anything else. Be like Mary sitting at the feet of Jesus, okay? Mary at the feet of Jesus, just soaking in everything that the Lord is saying. Seek God with all your heart. And if you do, you will find him. Call upon him and he will show you great and mighty things. Love you guys.